إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة. أيها المؤمنون، عباد الله، the past few weeks have been trying for many of us as Muslims. Recently, there was an earthquake in Morocco, and shortly after that, floods that killed thousands. In fact, the death toll is over 10,000 now. And this is something that brings grief and sorrow and heartache to many of the believers. And it should. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith of Nu'man in Bukhari and Muslim, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ الْجَسَدِ. The example of the believers in their compassion and mercy and love for one another is like one body. إِذَا اشْتَكَ مِنْهُ عُضْوٌ تَدَاعَ لَهُ سَائِرُ الْجَسَدِ بِسَهْرِ وَالْحُمَّةِ. If one limb, it complains, it's in pain, the entire body will react to this with fever and sleeplessness. So this should be the state of the believer, that our hearts, at least to some extent, have been moved by what happened. And the least that you're doing is saying, may Allah have mercy upon them, and making dua for them. As this is the way of the believer towards another. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. The believing men and women, they're allies and supporters of one another. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ ويطيعون الله ورسوله أولئك سيرحمهم الله إن الله عزيز حكيم. The believing men and women, they're allies to one another. They command with good and prohibit evil. They establish the prayer. They give the zakah, and they obey Allah and His Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Those are the ones who Allah He will have mercy upon. فعباد الله, there has to be this ولاية, this support for your brethren in Islam, those who are struggling, those who are going through hardship. And that the least that we can be doing is making dua for them, like we heard. And these events, they bring so many things to mind, such as the prophecy of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said in the hadith of Abi Huraira in Bukhari and Muslim, that from the signs of the coming of the hour, أنه يقبض العلم, the knowledge will be lifted, وتكثر الزلازل, and that the earthquakes, they will become many, ويتقرب الزمان, and that time will shorten. Time will shorten, and we're not seeing this. 1 week to another, it's almost like 2 days have passed and you're already in another Jumu'ah. True prophecies of our Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَتَكْثُرُ الْفِتْنِ وَالْهَرْجِ. And fitn, trials, they will continue to multiply and increase, as well as al-harj. And he said al-qatl, killings, they will become widespread. And everywhere you turn, you find this. Fitn and killings and so on. From the things that our Messenger told us, وَهُوَ دَالٌ عَلَى صِدْقِ نَبُوَّتِهِ, which is a sign that he was a true prophet from Allah جَلَّ فِي عُلَى. عباد الله, there also comes to mind how quickly a person's life can change. All of a sudden, after being in ease and being in a state of tranquility and being in your house with your family members and perhaps having a meal and a laugh, all of a sudden the command from Allah عز وجل comes. He said, جَلَّ وَعَلَى, وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلِ الْقُرَىٰ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا لَفَتَحْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ بَرَكَاتٍ مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبُوا فَأَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Allah جَلَّ وَعَلَى, He says, if a people from a village, they were to have taqwa and iman, we would open for them provisions from the heavens and the earth. But they denied. So we took them because of what they used to earn. To our people of a village, do they feel safe from our planning that we will take them and seize them while they are asleep? أَوَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا ضُحًا وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ. Do our people of a village perceive that they are safe from our planning and we will not take them in the duha, the morning hours, while they're in leisure? أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ. Do they feel safe from the plan of Allah? فَلَا يَأْمَنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. For no one ever feels safe from the planning of Allah except the people who are lost, the people who are destroyed. عباد الله, we should never feel safe that nothing can happen to me. Look at me, how good of a Muslim I am. How much I pray, and how much I give zakat, and how much I've done umrah, and so on and so forth. أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ. Are we safe from the planning of Allah? The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, in the hadith of Ibn Abbas in the Sunan of Abi Dawud, he used to say from his dua, وَمْكُرْ لِي وَلَا تَمْكُرْ عَلَيَّ. Oh Allah, plan for me and do not plan against me. وَهُوَ رَسُولُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And he's the Messenger of the Lord of the worlds. And he's saying, oh Allah, plan for me, do not plan against me. Humility in front of Rabbul Alameen. So ibadallah, our lives can change in an instance. Perhaps some of us may not return to our house now. ماذا أعددت لنقاء ربك? The true question is, what have you prepared for meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Ibadallah, Allah, he tells us that he destroyed people for the oppression that they committed. He tells us about past nations. The sins that they committed was a reason for their destruction. فكلنا أخذنا بذنبه فمنهم من أرسلنا عليه حاصبا. All of them we took due to their sins. From them are those who we sent a violent wind. ومنهم من أخذته الصيحة. And from those nations were those who a loud cry destroyed an entire nation. A loud cry and they're gone. ومنهم من خسفنا به الأرض. And from them are those who the earth swallowed. ومنهم من أغرقنا. And from them are those who were caused to drown. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ. And it was never that Allah would oppress them. وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ. But they used to oppress their own selves. عباد الله, oppression in its categories. ذُلْمُ الْعَبْدِ نَفْسَهُ. The servant oppressing himself with the sins we are doing and what we're watching and what we're listening to and where we're going and who we're with. Oppression to ourselves, this is a reason for our destruction. Oppressing others is a reason for our destruction. وَإِذَا اجْتَمَعَ نُوعَ ذُلْمٍ. Oppressing oneself and oppressing others, when this unites, it's even worse. It's even worse. عباد الله, these are the junood of Allah Azza wa Jal. These are the armies of Allah. وَمَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّهُ. No one knows the army, the number of the army of Allah, but Him. It is He Jalla wa Ala who sends these ayat. He sends these signs as a reason for us to wake up out of our slumber. Wake up and turn back to Him. He says, جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ وَمَا نُرْسِلُ بِالْآيَاتِ إِلَّا تَخْوِفًا. And we do not send these signs except to instill fear into the people. These are the signs of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, في زمنه لما خسفت الشمس, when there occurred a solar eclipse during the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَخَرَجَ مِنْ بَيْتِهِ فَزِعًا مُسْرِعًا إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ. He left his house in panic, hastening to the masjid, so much so that the narration indicates that he accidentally took the garment of his wife. This is how much he panicked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he comes to the house of Allah, وَيَبْدَأْ فِي صَلَاةٍ طَوِيلَةٍ. And he starts a long salah, praying and praying and praying to Allah Azza wa Jal, until the eclipse is lifted. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to them, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ يُرْسِلُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. Allah Azza wa Jal, He sends these ayat to instill fear. فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ شَيْئًا مِّن ذَٰلِكَ فَافْزَعُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ. And if you see anything like that, then race towards the prayer. وَإِلَى ذِكْرِهِ, and towards remembrance of Allah. وَالصَّدَقَةِ, and giving sadaqah. وَاسْتِغْفَارِهِ, and seeking forgiveness. عباد الله, that's the answer. Seek forgiveness. Give sadaqah. Make dua. Pray. This is how we are able to lift these calamities from ourselves. But if we're heedless and it was just another calamity, another problem that happened, may Allah have mercy on that, we don't have any care really. Wallahi, this is not a good sign. As perhaps tomorrow it's us. Perhaps you are the one who the people are making dua for. Perhaps it's your janazah that's being carried and your salah that's being established. Ibadallah, the heedlessness is a reason for our destruction. And it destroyed many of those who came before us. When Allah, He destroyed the people of Lot, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَجَعَلْنَا عَالِيَهَا سَافِلَهَا وَأَمْطَرْنَا عَلَيْهَا حِجَارَةً مِنْ سِجِّلٍ مَنْضُودٍ. We turned the whole city upside down and we sent upon them clay pellets of fire. مُسَوَّمَةً عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ. They were marked, the ulama mentioned. Every one of those bolts or every one of those pellets of clay, they were marked with a sign. Allah knows Azza wa Jalla what those signs were. Some have said that it was the name of every individual that was going to be struck, his name was on one of them. And this is nothing to Allah Azza wa Jal. Did Allah Azza wa Jal not create fingerprints of every person that are different? About Allah, every single one of those people's names they have mentioned that was on those pellets that were destroyed by Allah Azza wa Jal. مُسَوَّمَةً عِنْدَ رَبِّكْ وَمَا هِيَ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ بِبَعِيدٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal says it is not far from those who oppress. Oppressing ourselves, the calamity is not far from us, ibadallah. So it is a must that we awaken from this heedlessness that is overtaking our hearts. And we take these ayat seriously and these signs of Allah seriously. And that we do not remain in this ghafla. The heedlessness that the shaitan is putting us in. This spell and this trance that we're living. We must unlatch these shackles of the shaitan and come forward to Allah Azza wa Jal in tawbah and sincerity. Allah Jalla wa'ala, He says in the hadith Qudsi, إِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي شِبْرًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ ذِرَاعًا. If my servant draws near to me a handspan's length, I will draw near him a forearm's length. وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا. And if he draws near to me a forearm's length, I will draw near to him an entire arm's length. وَإِذَا أَتَانِي يَمْشِي أَتَيْتُهُ هَرْوَلَةً. And if my servants come walking to me, then I will go to them quickly. Ibadallah, Allah is there for us to accept our repentance, to forgive us of our sins, to aid us and assist us in the times of difficulty and hardship. ولكن it's like the Prophet said, تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. Make yourself known to Allah in the time of ease and affluence. Allah, He knows you in the time of hardship. Make yourself known to Him at that time. When is it that we really, really want to go back to Allah? When the thiqal, the heaviness is unbearable and you feel like you're going to crumble. So you go back to Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Allah. ما الذي منعك أن تتضرع إلى الله قبل ذلك? What prevented you from returning back to Allah prior to that? Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَاهُمْ بِالْعَذَابِ فَمَا اسْتَكَانُوا لِرَبِّهِمْ وَمَا يَتَضَرَّعُونَ. And we took them with a punishment, but they did not make themselves submissive before Allah, nor did they make themselves humble. Ibadallah, yuridu rabbuka mink an yaraka mutadhallilan bayna yaday. Allah, He wants to see from you humility before Him. Humility before the King, al-Malik al-Muqtadir. Show your humility at all times, and you know at the time when the shidda comes, rabbuka ma'ak. Allah Azza wa Jal, He will be with you, and He will assist you, and make things easy for you. Ibadallah, these are all from the lessons and experiences that we take in this life and this dunya. And as-sa'id man wu'idha bighayrih. The one who is fortunate in this life is someone who is admonished by others. He looks towards what's going on and he realizes that this is a lesson for me. And the worst of states is this ghafla, just heedlessness. And some will say, but why did Allah destroy them? They're Muslims. Why doesn't it come to this country and America and so on and so forth? Ibadallah, لا يسألوا عن ما يفعل وهم يسألون. رب العالمين is not asked about what He does, but they will be questioned. لله في أفعاله حكمة بالغة. Allah, He has in His actions a wisdom which is profound. And what is it besides returning back to Allah which happened anyway? What is it besides this? It's only returning back to Allah which we have been promised. من لم يمت بالسيف مات بغيره. If you do not die by the sword, you will die by other than the sword. تعددت الأسباب والموت واحد. There are various ways of death, but death in itself is one. What's important is how you return back to Allah, not how you were destroyed. Were there not Sahaba who died in the Ta'un of Amawas, which is in the region of Palestine? A Ta'un, a plague that Allah unleashed. Then you have Sahaba, the likes of Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Alim min ulama al-Sahaba, and he dies from a plague. And Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah, Aminu hadhi al-Ummah, he is the trustee of this nation of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he dies from a plague. That's not important how you die. What's important is how you return back to Allah Azza wa Jal at the time of your death. عباد الله. Allah, He tells us in the Noble Quran, وَإِن مِّن قَرْيَةٍ إِلَّا نَحْنُ مُهْلِكُوهَا قَبْلَ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُوهَا عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا كَانَ ذَلِكَ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَسْطُورًا. There has never been a village except that Allah He would destroy it before the hour comes, or He will punish it a severe punishment, and that this was written with Allah Azza wa Jal in the preserved tablet. So some of the ulama have taken an approach to this ayah, that what's being intended is oppressive villages. And some have said it's general to all villages. ولكن المؤمن إذا مات من ذلك يبعث على نيته. But the believer, if he dies in that state, then he will be brought forward upon his intention. What is your intent? What's in your heart? At this moment, analyze yourself, Abdullah. What is the goals that you have for today? How many of them consists of disobeying Allah and being sinful towards Allah and rebellious towards your Creator? وَهُوَ مُرَاقِبٌ لَكَ. And He is overseeing you and watching your steps. عباد الله. ثُمَّ يُبْعَثُونَ عَلَى نِيَّاتِهِمْ. This is what the Prophet, he told Aisha, the people. They will be brought forward upon their intentions. And the Messenger, he also told us this from the hadith of Ibn Umar in Bukhari and Muslim. إِذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يُعَذِّبَ قَوْمًا أَوْ عَذَابَ قَوْمٍ. If Allah, He desires to punish a people, He will punish them. ثُمَّ بُعِثُوا عَلَى أَعْمَالِهِمْ. Then they will be resurrected based upon their deeds. فَلْنَشْتَغِلْ فِي إِصْلَاحِ أَعْمَالِنَا وَتَطْهِيرِ قُلُوبِنَا. Let us occupy ourselves with rectifying our actions and purifying our hearts before the time comes of reckoning and we return back to Allah Azza wa Jal. وَلَيْسَ لَنَا سَبِيلٌ إِلَى إِصْلَاحِ. And we have no path to rectify ourselves. نسأل الله عز وجل السلام والعافية والحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين، إله الأولين والآخرين، خالق السماوات والأرضين، وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله. This is a wake up call, inshallah. A wake up call for the heedless. A wake up call for every one of us. This is a reason for you to turn back to Allah. This is a reason for you to be thankful to Allah Azza wa Jal. And there are wisdoms, like we mentioned, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does this. Wisdoms that we may know, and some of them we may not know. But we believe in Him Jalla wa Ala, and we know أن الله عز وجل وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. That He doesn't oppress anyone in the slightest. عباد الله. When events like this come to happen, there is an argument that is usually put forward by the atheists and those who are ill in their hearts. So they say, if there was a God, why would something like this happen? If there was actually God, why would this happen? And like this and like that, from what the shaitan has beautified for them. And this argument is important for us to tackle as a Muslim ummah. This is an argument that the presence of evil negates the presence of our Creator. And this in essence means nothing. It means nothing in reality until they're able to prove, until they're able to prove that the presence of evil, it negates the presence of a Creator. Who's able to prove this? Who's able to prove this? That the presence of evil, death, tragedies, calamities, that because of this, 100% there's no Creator. Who's able to prove this? نحن نقول فيها حكمة. We say as Muslims there is a wisdom that they may not know. And in fact they do not know due to the hearts being blackened by the sins that they are committing. And عباد الله, this argument in essence means nothing. If a person was on a runaway train and the train tragedy happens, people are dying. This child, their head has hit the wall and they're bleeding to death. This woman is dying here. This man, his limbs are severed. And you're seeing all of this. No one will ever say, this train, it doesn't have a manufacturer because of this. But when it comes to السماوات والأرض, the heavens and the earth have been perfected by رب العالمين. And these seas and all of these things which are in front of us, we're quick to return and say, there's no creator because of this and that. Look at the insolence and look at the foolishness of a people who Allah Azza wa Jalla has turned away from His signs. وَمَا تُغْنِي الْآيَاتُ وَالنُّذُرُ عَنْ قَوْمٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Allah says, His ayat and His signs and His warners, they will not avail anything of people who do not believe. فَآمِنْ بِرَبِّكَ. believe in Allah, iman and sahihan, a correct iman, and return back in repentance, and let us hasten to Allah Azza wa Jalla's mercy. نسأل الله جل في علا بأسمائه الحسنى وصفاته العلا أن يغفر لنا خطايانا وسيئاتنا. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات. اللهم إنا على طاعتك، اللهم وفقنا فيه، اللهم قنا شر أنفسنا، اللهم قنا شر أنفسنا وشر الشياطين، وارحم من مات أو جرح في تلك الحوادث يا رب العالمين. والحمد لله رب العالمين.